I just got back from Okinawa, and it was replete with command influence, unlawful command influence, where you had members of the command or senior members really trying to influence the testimony of junior subordinate members of the command who wanted to go to bat for our client and testify for them. Now, at a court-martial, this is going to be illegal. At a court-martial, you have the ability to go before a military judge and file a motion. They say command influence or unlawful command influence is the mortal enemy of the military justice system. But in a board of inquiry, which is often more like a street fight than it is an actual trial, there are very little rules. There's very little recourse. And oftentimes you can't even prove it's happening. But we saw this firsthand at the last board we did. Now, just to reiterate, what is a administrative separation board? Well, instead of a court-martial or instead of a trial, it is the Army's, the Air Force, the Navy's, the Marine Corps. It's their method for separating a service member for misconduct. Oftentimes this happens, starts with NJP and Article 15. There's a general officer memorandum of reprimand that's placed into your file. And then from there, the command will try to administratively separate you. Now, if you have more than 6 years of service or if the command is recommending an other than honorable discharge, either one of those rates your right to have an administrative separation board. At the board, you can have an attorney present. We routinely fly all over the world, actually, to do administrative separation boards, in particular for senior non-commissioned officers or officers. And you have the right to present evidence and to challenge the evidence against you. But there are no rules of evidence. So there's no military judge. The board is oftentimes made up of a senior officer and two enlisted or two officers and an enlisted member, depending on the makeup of the board, your rank, and the particular circumstances. But what often happens is you'll have, maybe it's a first sergeant, maybe it's a platoon sergeant, you'll have individuals who want to testify on your behalf, who are going to go to bat for you and say, hey, this is a great soldier, he should be retained, I don't believe there's a basis that's been met, I deploy with him. Oftentimes they would say a lot of great things about them, and then the command gets involved. Then what happens is a company commander, a battalion commander, a brigade commander will actually pull that soldier aside and tell them, don't testify. I don't want you testifying at that board. If you testify, bad things are going to happen. And that's illegal, but it happens all the time. How do we know this happens? Because at the last board we went to, we had several members of the chain of command, several members who served with our client who were absolutely ready, willing, and able to testify at our client's board. But what happened is the morning of or the night before, they said, hey, sir, I really can't testify. My command told me it was a conflict of interest. I really don't feel comfortable anymore. And then they don't want to testify. And then we have to go before the board members and compel them to testify or either cut them loose. There's a lot of different ways to handle it. But the reality is this happens week in and week out. And if you don't believe that's going to happen potentially in your board, or if that doesn't happen, you're lying to yourself or you're wrong, because it's the commander who initiates the separation. And oftentimes they don't want their service members, their soldiers or their subordinates testifying for your client or for our client when that goes against their wishes. So oftentimes we can have 8, 9, 10, 15 people ready and willing and able to go before a board to testify the night before a board comes, and they start dropping like flies. And you have to know how to handle that. You have to be able to go to the board president or go to the board members and explain what's going on and to be firm about what's going on, or even to call the commander, call the battalion commander in to testify about what happened. And if they're lying about it, which oftentimes they will, they'll straight up lie under oath, or oftentimes they'll say nothing like this ever happened. You got to know how to cross-examine them, because people aren't witnesses for you for weeks and weeks and weeks, and all of a sudden the night before they suddenly said there's a conflict of interest. So that happens routinely. You have to be able to prevent that, because if you don't, you can lose your entire career. Because make no mistake about it, it's the command that wants you gone. And you may have 15 years, you may have 16 years, you may have 18 years of service. All of it can be flushed down the toilet, which is the equivalent of sometimes a $1 million, $2 million, $2.5 million value of a retirement, all flushed down the toilet because maybe of an NJP or of a GOMAR where you've recovered from it and you've earned the right to stay in the military. But your character witnesses, the command will oftentimes try to get to them. And you need to have a strong attorney. You need to have someone who knows what the hell they're doing to go and fight that. Otherwise, you're going to be out. You're going to be gone. And you're going to lose everything you've worked for, because the command is going to get the final say whether they did it legally or not.